locking nuts. These are nylon insert lock nuts. You can see in here, they have a nylon insert. That's why they call them nylon insert. And what happens is when you put the bolt through, it starts to thread the nylon and then puts pressure on the screw and prevents it from vibrating loose. To the left, I have a finish nut, and to the right, I have a jam nut. And jam nuts, just to give you what these do, you use two nuts together and then you tighten them up against each other. That's why they call them jam nuts. You use them together, you tighten them up, but typically that's how they're used. They're also used in tight areas where you can't have a full-size nut. They call this a stover or prevailing torque locking nut. So it has a locking mechanism that's built into this cone, and as you put it on, it starts to act like a locking nut. This is a two-way nut. So how do you tell a two-way nut? A little marking in the center. See it there? It's almost like a punch right in the center. And that shows that that's a two-way. So it's locking two-way, no matter you put it on or off. Once you start to screw up to that size, it will start to lock. So I just reached it now. I'm not going to continue, but either way I put this on, it's going to start locking. A serrated flange nut. This is a nut. It has an integral flange built into it, and on the backside, you can see that it's serrated. That's usually used in applications where you have some type of metal sheeting or something that has metal, and you tighten it down, and those serrations prevent it from backing off. This is called a K-Lock nut or Keps lock nut. And these have these little wings that are here, and this is a free rolling washer lock nut. So those little wings get tightened, and the key to this is not to over tighten it. Once you over tighten this, it's no longer a lock nut, and that free rolling washer gets crushed, and it just doesn't work for you anymore. So the key to this is not to torque it down too tight. A castle nut. These are typically used in cars. You'll find them on axles when they hold on wheels and bearings, rotors. We're going to drill out a bolt, slide the cotter pin in to show you how this is locked in place.